range from Calvin Klein, and the sportswear is out of this world. It's really something. And a brand like Max, which you normally associate with just blue jeans or t-shirts, has come up with an ethnic festive wear collection of lovely layered looks, a lot of zari embroidery. So it's going to be quite exciting. And we have a Bangalore brand called Rare Rabbit, which does menswear. And they've done a very European collection this year. So lots of color, lots of glamour, lots of glitter. So I think you're going to have a great time. So don't miss the shows tonight. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. So, hi, Armaan. I'm Zisha from Rarebab. We have a question for you. So do you have anything like you're looking forward to? Ki main ab Bangalore mein hu, toh I definitely have to eat masala dosa. Or you know, the meal on the banana leaf. Have you got such a plan? I have to do this in Bangalore.
I'm a very big foodie actually. So I'm going to be asking all the people which are the best restaurants and I have some... So I'm definitely going to ask what are the good restaurants to go to and you guys suggest me and I'll go there. I'm going to ask after the press conference, I will definitely ask them.
Hi, Armaan. So I have a question related to music.
Okay.
So when you sing any song which is non-Hindi or any language for that matter,
yeah.
Have you tried learning the language? Because when you sing and you understand the lyric, there's a lot more feel that you can put in the...
Definitely. But obviously I sing all my songs understanding what the lyrics are anyway. Because if I don't understand what I'm singing, I won't be able to emote. It's not necessary to learn the language per se, because as singers, we are expected to sing in different languages every day. I go into a studio and probably there'll be a Telugu song waiting for me, or a Kannada song, or a Bengali song, and I'm expected to sing the song within 3 hours because the booking period of the studio is that much. So I've just developed a habit of listening to the song, writing down the lyrics in English, and there are certain things that I do on the sheet of paper that make me differentiate how it's pronounced. Like a lot of l is used in Kannada, so you know, all those things I've learned over the years. For me now, Kannada has become like Hindi. I sing a lot of songs in Kannada, so it's become very easy for me. And before singing, I definitely ask the lyric writer what the lyric means. But I don't think it's important to learn the language per se, but I would love to one day probably speak to all of you guys in Kannada. Hopefully in the coming few years, I will become full Kannada.
Thank you. Thank you a lot. My question is to Armaan. Hi, Ivan.
Hi.
So I just want to know how the journey has been so far from Sarugama to Bollywood, and now you're moving to other markets as well.
Yeah.
So how do you look forward to your journey? And do you also look forward to sing other songs in other languages as well?
Well, I've since the age of 10, I've been singing in almost all the languages. Just a few languages are left, like Assamese is left, Kashmiri is left, a few like that is left, but otherwise I've sung almost in all the South Indian languages, Telugu, Tamil, Malayalam, Kannada, and then Bengali and Gujarati as well. For me, I've always felt like India is not just Hindi and not just Bollywood music. For me, when I come to a city like Bangalore, I'll probably sing 80% of my Hindi songs, but that 20% of you know, Kannada songs make the local people really feel special because they connect with me in a more different way. So my aim has always been to spread my wings across India, and I feel like we have a lot of potential to take India global, and we have so many languages. I think we should embrace our culture and from each state. So I've always, I've not planned it, but it just so happened that whenever I sang a song in a different language, other languages approached me to sing a song in their language. So step by step, over the last 10, 12 years, I've sung in almost all the languages and feel special. Because so many people come up to me and say, they've not heard Main Hoon Hero Tera, they've not heard this, but they've heard the local song. So for them, they connect on that level, and I'm really happy if I can connect with everyone on every level.
Thank you very much.
Thank you so much.
Excuse me, Armaan.
Yes.
So, Armaan, this is Shogato from Radio 90.4. And what I want to ask is, it's a public concert happening.
Yeah.
It's your first public concert in Bangalore.
In Bangalore, yeah.
Yeah. So there are a lot of people, a lot of youngsters are coming who idolize you as their role model.
Yes.
So what would be your message to all those young musicians who want to pursue music as a profession?
I think today is the one of the best periods in music and in the film industry or the non-film industry. We have the access of YouTube, we have the access of Instagram, Facebook and all these platforms where I feel anyone can upload just a clip of them singing and you just don't know what will go viral, you know. We have such platforms available. There are many singers, example Justin Bieber and all these singers who have become big through social media platforms. And now I see a lot of the Indian population using social media rampantly. And you know, we're seeing you know, people who don't have you know, proper access to electricity or whatever, but they're still using a smartphone and they still have social media and stuff like that. So they're getting connected. India is getting connected. So it's the right time to upload. Even a 1 minute clip can change your life. I feel so. So social media is the big thing today. So, and I feel that is the best time. Youngsters should not, personally I feel like reality shows are good, but social media is the way to go. That's the future.
Two more questions and then we could have, we have to wind up.
कभी आपने सोचा कि काश वो स्टोरी मेरे ऊपर होती तो आप कभी आपने सोचा नहीं?
कभी नहीं, रोज सोचते क्योंकि इतनी अच्छी अच्छी कहानियां उन्होंने लिखी हैं और तो इट हैज बीन अ ग्रेट थिंग फॉर एज एन एक्टर फॉर सलमान और फॉर मी ड्यूरिंग दिस पीक पीरियड व्हेन ही वाज राइटिंग सच अमेजिंग स्टोरीज लाइक शोले दीवार जंजीर त्रिशूल मोहन हाथी मेरे साथी शक्ति ऑल दीज ग्रेट फिल्म्स ही इज रिटन. So it had been great for, you know, when Salman was as a budding actor or I was as a budding actor to, you know, be a part of it. Because let's not forget, you know, the film that really made Bachchan Saab was also Zanjeer. And till then, you know, he was also struggling with not such great hits and all that stuff. And that one role, that one film catapulted him into a major stardom. And then he followed it up with some many films with my dad, like Diwar and, you know, was, Zanjeer was there, Diwar was there. Shole was there, Dawn was there, Majboor was there, Shakti was there, but that is not there. So these are the films that, you know, Bachchan Saab did with that. So it would have been great to work, you know, though Salman did do one film with dad, that was Pathar Ke Phool, and then, so unfortunately, didn't have an opportunity. And now he kind of doctors our script, so whenever we write a script under our production, we kind of go to him, and we are ready to take the flag. And sometimes we don't listen to him and then he turns around and says, "Dekha, main tumko kya bola, usko correct karna chahiye." I would like to mention that even when Dabang was happening, and almost like not even a month before I was going on floor, I went to him and I said, "You know what, it will not be right. I'm making my first film as a producer. I've got a script writer like Salim Khan in my house. There was freaky advice with Sakti. I should make him hear the subject." And I made him hear the subject and he could pinpoint a very, very major flaw that we had in the script. And he said, "Have you noticed this?" And both director and me was like, "Actually, we did. What do we do about it?" He says, "Aisa karo, vaisa karo." And he corrected that scenario. And we thank him for that because, you know, he's being a master. You know, he's like a...